Hi, good morning. This is Richa Goswami, Global Head of Customer International for HSBC. Just answering some questions that we got post the panel. The first was on tips for career switching. Whenever I'm asked this question, and just from my own personal experience of having moved from banking to startup to FMCG and back to banking, is always start with why. Why are you looking to switch? Are you leaving a boss you're unhappy with? Are you leaving a culture that does not agree with you? Are you leaving for more financial compensation? Are you leaving because you need to move with your family? I think the why is really important, because once you have a good handle on why you're switching, then I think it becomes a lot more easier for you to start getting focused. So that's the first thing. The second thing is I found that networking is super important, because a lot of the roles that you get are just not advertised. It's someone that knows you, that takes a chance on you. So be really open to networking, reaching out to people in the industries that you're interested in, ask people for a coffee, connect with them on LinkedIn. You know, I think that that has really helped. But the third thing is your mindset. You know, you have to be really open to going back a bit to the start and learning. So when I went to Johnson & Johnson from banking, I just said to myself, the first year is like going back to university. It's a new industry, it's a new culture, it's a new business model, and it's nothing that I know. So you really need to be like a student and be really open and, you know, listen and learn, and don't go with your biases. So start with the why. Be super clear why you want to do it. Then come up with a list of industries that you need, that you want to be a part of. Start following those brands on LinkedIn. Get to know people in that space. And then most importantly, be really open to learning. The second question that I had is, life is changing a lot and is fast. Is it really possible to come up with qualities and skills that hold the test of time? I think it's more your mental DNA and makeup, like, you know, the ability to show resilience, the ability to have humility to learn, the ability to stay curious, the ability to multitask and how you handle yourself under pressure, the ability to stay creative. These, I think, are all skills or attributes that stand the test of time. In terms of domain expertise, you need to keep learning and keep reinventing, because especially for me in the space of, say, digital, it changes every day. So what I knew a couple of years ago works, but it will not make me best in the world, right? So you need to constantly be learning, setting aside time to learn. I set aside time on a weekly basis to read. I still do online courses. I sometimes take part in, like external events, because it forces me to read, to think, to constantly challenge myself. But on your personal attributes, I think a lot of that can stand the test of time. Lastly is a question I get asked a lot, like, what are the tips that you would give someone looking to be a startup? I would say a couple of things. The first is have a really clear idea. It goes back to the why you think this is a great idea and who would benefit from this idea. So a lot of times we get really excited because it's our idea, but it might not work for the customer. So be really clear, number one, who's the customer? What is their pain point that you're trying to solve? What is it that you're doing that is unique? How are you going to do this? And what would you need to make it happen? I think once you've got that clarity of thought, you've put it down, you know, whether it's in a business case, start thinking through that. Then it's always good to test it with the potential customers you'd like to attract. And people are happy to, you know, talk to you. Just say, hey, this is the idea I have. You'd be a potential customer. Does this work for you? So I would not just jump straight in. I would have clarity on the pain point that this is solving. What is the customer needs are, most importantly? How can I service them? What differentiates it? And once you've got all of that, then just go ahead, start thinking through how can you get, mentorship? What schemes are there to help you? Like in Singapore, there are schemes that from everything from helping you register your startup, to helping you get financial like loans for your computers and other stuff, right? So start figuring that piece out. Don't hesitate to ask people to help you. Be super resilient and have a lot of agility, because your first idea will not be your last idea. If there is failure, I always think of it as a learning opportunity. Make sure that you learn from it, right? Like, what could you have done differently? Be courageous. It's not always going to be easy, right? But I think if you're hungry, you have a good idea why you're doing it, you'll be amazing, and have fun along the way, as hard as that might be. So thank you for having me, and speak with you really soon.